Bond King. Bill Gross prediction for 2018, the bear bond market is here, market crash 2018. China and Bill Gross warn that the bear market is approaching. The loss of China as an investor is something the United States should start worrying about. Far from how some Trump voters may absorb this possibility, it could spell significant market trouble for them and many other Americans. The alarm comes from Bill Gross, who has made a reputation for knowing when to buy or sell bonds. They don't call him the Bond King because he has a large collection of 007 DVDs. In a recent interview, Gross said he's making a bearish bet on the bond market through the Global Unconstrained Bond Fund, through Janus Henderson, the firm he manages. Gross expects U.S. treasuries to drop in value because yields are rising quickly. Yields increase as treasuries prices fall. Why is China losing confidence in U.S.? What's driving the loss of confidence in the U.S. that a drop in treasury values implies? Bond King Bill Gross has no doubt, it's all because of China, which has been selling off some of its U.S. assets. Gross noted that high-yield bonds, aka junk bonds, have become especially risky despite them having become popular since the 2008 financial crisis. This marks an important risk, given the potential for U.S. China sanctions over trade or North Korea. Bonds, their market, and yields are one of the barometers of overall stock market sentiment. If the Chinese have started to pull out from U.S. treasuries in a noticeable manner enough to trouble Bill Gross, it's a sign that an equities bear market may be around the proverbial corner. Because of the higher yields, portfolio managers could start shifting their clients' savings from stocks to bonds/treasuries. This could happen faster than even Gross or Jeffrey Gundlach, for that matter, might think. Stock values are at absolute highs, but nobody can offer a decent explanation for these record valuations. Indeed, there is a perception that the stock rally could end abruptly amid a series of lingering risks from geopolitics and from too much exuberance, perhaps driven by the economic growth that Trump's tax cuts have promoted. Certainly, corporate earnings, that traditional and perhaps outdated harbinger of stock valuations, have been rather flat for the past 4 years or so. The small corrections also point to the fact that when sentiment turns bearish, it will do so in a spectacularly bad, herd manner, producing a major market crash. Bearish sentiment is growing everywhere. That's what Janus fund manager Bill Gross and China are worried about. Gross said that he's bearish on US treasuries, UK gilts, and German bonds. The reason investors should worry is the translation of all this. Whether you understand the bond market or not, there are worrying signs. Institutional investors have begun to sing from the songbook of those who worry the markets are no longer making sense. China, being one of the main buyers of U.S. debt, has sent the first shockwaves, noting it finds the U.S. market unattractive. Central banks, from the Federal Reserve to the European Central Bank or the Bank of Japan, share China's concerns. Yields are increasing in many major economies, from Spain to Germany. China is merely the trigger, and there's little that can be done. President Trump has put much pressure on Beijing. In turn, the Chinese want to reduce their debt levels. This combination, that is, China's perception of U.S. hostility and its own economic needs, explains the deeply nationalistic nature of China's motivation for selling off U.S. debt. In other words, they won't easily back down. Don't ignore the impact from central banks' policies. Moreover, there are concerns over how the advanced economies will absorb the impact of rising interest rates, as central banks might terminate quantitative easing (QE) policies. QE has lasted longer than many had expected. The low interest rates were needed to boost economic activity in countries that endured difficult conditions after the 2008 subprime crash. The problem is that once more investors catch on to the fact that bond markets are falling, favoring yields, it will be impossible to stop money managers from making their move. The effect of the U.S. tax bill will be to limit its ability to adjust to inflation. Every point of higher interest means much higher debt payments. Lower taxes make servicing the current debt payments more problematic already. Finally, consider the inevitable demise of the retail industry. It's no mystery that the rise and increasing dominance of Amazon.com, Incorporated, NASDAQ, Amazon, and the online units of many retail chains has caused a hemorrhage of jobs in the traditional retail industry. There's also the drive toward further automation and artificial intelligence. Thus, in the mid and long terms, there are substantial systemic risks to the overall health of the American economy. We have tested the limits of the bull market since 2009. With every new record high, the chances for a massive and heavier fall increase. Stock market crash 2018, why the fundamentals start mattering again. Stock market crash 2018 and beyond will only occur when recession is imminent. Will the stock market crash in 2018? Investors have been asking the same question for the last 5 years. Each time, the answer was a resounding no. So could 2018 be the year when the dam finally breaks? Many bears would settle for a leak instead of a torrent. The relentless stock market rally has defied all logic. Corporate earnings growth has been essentially flat since 2013, yet the market keeps rallying. But instead of moving up with conviction, it's mostly been melting forward. This has led to one-sided trade, with the bulls herded to one side. The merciless melt-up in stocks is leading to an ultimate paradox for investors. Do investors buy in at nosebleed levels, or wait for pullbacks to add positions? After all, if the question is when the next stock market crash will happen, nobody wants to be a top tick bad holder. The answer to this question, for now, is to dive in head first. Inflows into exchange-traded funds, ETFs, have remained incredibly strong this year. Through the first 7 months of 2017, $272 billion has flowed into the stock markets via ETFs. That's almost matched the 2016 record inflows total of $287 billion. If stock investors are worried about chasing overvalued stocks, they aren't showing it. But there's danger with investors chasing equities in lieu of any half-decent correction. Some analysts are worried about a one-sided market. This occurs when everyone is investing in the same direction, leading to heroin sell-offs once investors sell at the same time. So far, any real damage has been confined to a day or two. But this won't last forever. Investors conditioned to buy the dip will be in for a rude awakening soon. How strong has the market melt-up been? Consider that it's been 18 months since the market has had a small 5% stock market correction, June 2016 Brexit sell-off. Furthermore, the S&P 500 hasn't corrected even 3% in over 13 months, the longest streak since 1994. It's absolutely mind-blowing when you consider all the macro risk, Trump, terrorism, you name it. Even market veterans are perplexed by the market action. 50-year NYSE floor manager Art Cashin is having trouble explaining things. Asked to explain how U.S. stocks have continued to outperform while the 10-year Treasury yields have remained sub-2.5%. Cashin acknowledged that he's never seen anything like today's market. That's telling, considering that Cashin started his career in the 1960s. I've been doing this for over 50 years and I've never seen anything like it, so it is rather odd. Cashin, specifically, was referencing stocks' abnormal relationship with low yields. Low yields imply tepid growth and low inflation, which historically is the opposite of what should happen during a rip-roaring rally. That in itself should be an ominous sign. As is the yield curve, which has recently crashed to 10-year lows. But he might have well been speaking for the entire market ecosystem, which is totally disregarding any traditional key economic indicator followed by investors. Specifically valuation, which, by any standard, is inflated beyond a reason. Will the current stock market rally continue in 2018? By now, it's common knowledge that the world stock indices have been driven almost exclusively by central bank CB liquidity. Not just in America, but Asia, Europe, Japan. Everywhere. This is no accident. The world's CBs are engaging in coordinated loose money policy. Much of it conducted through direct bond purchases to suppress interest rates. Another preferred method by the CBS is purchasing financial assets outright. The Swiss National Bank currently owns over 2,500 different equity positions. Combined, their stock market portfolio is worth over $90 billion. If it were a hedge fund, it would be one of the larger ones around. In years past, central banks left the markets alone unless the markets were crashing. As we can see, that's not the case anymore. The combination bond reinvestments being plowed back into the markets, direct asset purchases, and low borrowing costs have directly caused the bull market conditions today. Anyone trying to swim against the liquidity tide by shorting the market has been eviscerated. With all that said, will there be a stock market collapse 2018? After all, it's about looking forward, not backward. Peering into my crystal ball, I see signs that the current market order is coming to an end. Why? Because CP liquidity is finally about to dry up. The same forces driving everything sky high over the past several years are coming to an end. Worse than that, they may actually work against the market. There is no free lunch in economics. The Fed and ECB are about to halt bond purchases and allow bonds to mature in their existing portfolios. This is the so-called quantitative tightening program some people may have heard about. In America, the liquidity drain is set to peak at around $50 billion/month by late spring 2018. That's a lot of potential liquidity not entering the markets. The Fed has been busy telling us this normalization of their balance sheet will be like watching paint dry. But it's not true. A very expensive stock market needs all the liquidity it can muster to keep stocks grinding higher. It's not Joe Sixpack buying Amazon shares at $1,090 apiece. What happens after the program kicks in is anyone's guess. But there is no question that if the market is to continue higher or avoid hardship, it must rely on its own devices. Are you willing to take that bet? Are we heading to another stock market crash? Several stock market crash indicators point in that direction. I'm going to focus on one powerful one, the rapidly inverting yield curve. There's a reason why the US Treasury yield curve is followed so closely by market analysts. It's historically one of the best market indicators for predicting US recession. It's accurately called the last seven recessions without producing a false positive. The most common spreads are between 2-year and 10-year, 5-year and 30-year. When the shorter duration bonds yield more than the longer bonds, the yield curve becomes inverted. That's a powerful sign that economic growth and future expectation of growth plus inflation is weakening. The reason for the yield curve's amazing predictive power is rooted in sound business principles. Why would banks lend out money longer term when they could earn more interest income lending short term? Longer term lending has a greater risk of default and other disadvantages. Banks become more choosy about the money they shell out for big capital projects when the yield curve flattens out, choking out funding for big capital projects. This affects jobs, the velocity of money, and GDP. So what's the yield curve doing now? Despite the fact the economy has grown over 3% for two consecutive quarters, the yield curve is now trading at 10-year lows. Not since just before the Great Recession have we seen 2/10 and 5/30 spread so low. The 2/10 year curve above isn't flat yet, but it's narrowing fast. It suggests the bond market doesn't like the economic growth picture being painted by the financial media. Who are you going to believe? More poignantly, does anyone think the market can continue to melt up if growth falters and the Fed takes away the punch bowl? The answer is self-evident. Causes and effects of the stock market crash of 2018. The next Wall Street crash will be brought about by a recession. When corporate earnings collapse, nothing will be able to stop the torrent of selling from one-sided trade from an expensive market. The market trades at a CAPE ratio of about 31 right now. In a recession-induced earnings collapse, the CAPE could easily trade north of 100 if stock prices don't decline. That's not happening. Even in the tech bubble, the most expensive market in history, the CAPE topped out at around 50. So what will be the recession trigger? The inability to wring more consumerism out of a deeply indebted population. The substitution of income and savings for low-cost debt works out until saturation takes place. After that happens, nothing can stop the inevitable. When people and corporations run out of the ability to borrow, the system must clear in order for borrowing capacity to return. But the problem is, a massive amount of deleveraging will need to happen to reach that point. Literally, Decades of ultra-low rates and stimulus have pushed the credit boom to unimaginable levels. It's gotten so bad that the current economy needs roughly $3 of new debt to create $1 of real, inflation-adjusted, economic growth. Some analysts have suggested about $35 trillion of total credit market debt needs to be cleared before the problem will alleviate. The last time deleveraging on that scale occurred was during the Great Depression. The returns from the liquidity bubble keep diminishing over time. The check is almost due. Stock market crash predictions for 2018. Needless to say, I'm quite pessimistic about the stock market's chances going forward. I believe slower trend growth will be evident by the back half of 2018, and the CP liquidity drain will weigh on stocks. Shrinking liquidity and slowing growth is a bad recipe for keeping expensive stock prices elevated. The big question on my mind, besides timing, is whether the eventual sell-off will be orderly or chaotic. With the proliferation of top-heavy ETFs, passive index investors and record margin debt, it's hard to envision anything orderly about it. Perhaps central banks will find a way to cushion the blow. But perhaps a perfect storm of market turmoil is brewing. Nobody thinks it can happen in this environment. Most can't even remember the last time it did. And that's exactly why a bloodbath is a distinct possibility. If the S&P 500 can hold 2,115 a controlled demolition, I would consider this a major win. Just enough to let some air out without wrecking portfolios for the next 10 years. Welcome to this grand experiment in controlled marketomics. We hope it's different this time. I've begun to sing from the songbook of those who worry the markets are no longer making sense. China, being one of the main buyers of U.S. debt, has sent the first shockwaves, noting it finds the U.S. market unattractive. Central banks, from the Federal Reserve to the European Central Bank or the Bank of Japan, share China's concerns. Yields are increasing in many major economies, from Spain to Germany. China is merely the trigger. And there's little that can be done. President Trump has put much pressure on Beijing. In turn, the Chinese want to reduce their debt levels. This combination, that is, China's perception of U.S. hostility and its own economic needs, explains the deeply nationalistic nature of China's motivation for selling off U.S. debt. In other words, they won't easily back down. Don't ignore the impact from central banks' policies. Moreover, there are concerns over how the advanced economies will absorb the impact of rising interest rates, as central banks might terminate quantitative easing. Bond King, Bill Gross prediction for 2018, the bear bond market is here, market crash 2018. China and Bill Gross warn that the bear market is approaching. The loss of China as an investor is something the United States should start worrying about. Far from how some Trump voters may absorb this possibility, it could spell significant market trouble for them and many other Americans. The alarm comes from Bill Gross, who has made a reputation for knowing when to buy or sell bonds. They don't call him the Bond King because he has a large collection of 007 DVDs. In a recent interview, Gross said he's making a bearish bet on the bond market through the Global Unconstrained Bond Fund, through Janus Henderson, the firm he manages. Gross expects U.S. treasuries to drop in value because yields are rising quickly. Yields increases, treasuries prices fall. Why is China losing confidence in U.S.? What's driving the loss of confidence in the U.S. that a drop in treasury values implies? Bond King Bill Gross has no doubt, it's all because of China, which has been selling off some of its U.S. assets. Gross noted that high-yield bonds, aka junk bonds, have become especially risky despite them having become popular since the 2008 financial crisis. This marks an important risk, given the potential for U.S. China sanctions over trade or North Korea. Bonds, their market, and yields are one of the barometers of overall stock market sentiment. If the Chinese have started to pull out from U.S. treasuries in a noticeable manner enough to trouble Bill Gross, it's a sign that an equities bear market may be around the proverbial corner. Because of the higher yields, portfolio managers could start shifting their clients' savings from stocks to bonds/treasuries. This could happen faster than even grocer Jeffrey Gundlach, for that matter, might think. Stock values are at absolute highs, but nobody can offer a decent explanation for these record valuations. Indeed, there is a perception that the stock rally could end abruptly amid a series of lingering risks from geopolitics and from too much exuberance, perhaps driven by the economic growth that Trump's tax cuts have promoted. Certainly, corporate earnings, that traditional and perhaps outdated harbinger of stock valuations, have been rather flat for the past 4 years or so. The small corrections also point to the fact that when sentiment turns bearish, it will do so in a spectacularly bad herd manner, producing a major market crash. Bearish sentiment is growing everywhere. That's what Janus fund manager Bill Gross in China are worried about. Gross said that he's bearish on US treasuries, UK gilts, and German bonds. The reason investors should worry is the translation of all this. Whether you understand the bond market or not, there are worrying signs. Institutional investors in QE policies. QE has lasted longer than many had expected. The low interest rates were needed to boost economic activity in countries that endured difficult conditions after the 2008 subprime crash. The problem is that once more investors catch on to the fact that bond markets are falling, favoring yields, it will be impossible to stop money managers from making their move. The effect of the US tax bill will be to limit its ability to adjust to inflation. Every point of higher interest means much higher debt payments. Lower taxes make servicing the current debt payments more problematic already. Finally, consider the inevitable demise of the retail industry. It's no mystery that the rise and increasing dominance of Amazon.com, Incorporated, NASDAQ, Amazon, and the online units of many retail chains has caused a hemorrhage of jobs in the traditional retail industry. There's also the drive toward further automation and artificial intelligence. Thus, in the mid and long terms, there are substantial systemic risks to the overall health.